Elijah Moore, wide receiver for the New York Jets. And we've seen an up and down season from Elijah Moore. The first 4 weeks, all at least 87% of the snaps. He had 7, 5, 10, and 4 targets to start the year. But then it started going downhill, 73, 66, 16% of snaps. And finally, he's worked his way back up to over 80% of snaps week 14 against Buffalo. Yes, Corey Davis left this game, but Elijah Moore still commanded 10 targets. He got a red zone target, 104 air yards. That's the second highest of the season for Elijah Moore. He had the 6 receptions for 60 yards. He finishes the wide receiver 33 in full PPR. But here, this next week, the New York Jets get the Detroit Lions, and it is an absolutely smash matchup. I don't care who the starting quarterback is for the Jets. I hope that it's Mike White. But even if it's Joe Flacco, that's not going to be a downgrade for Elijah Moore in for his fantasy value. So you need to be going to get Elijah Moore. He is primed for a huge, huge out. If you like my content, make sure you hit that red subscribe button. It really, really helps the channel. And when I talk about like the matchups for the New York Jets, like Garrett Wilson, of course, pops in there. But Elijah Moore, there's no reason he should be outside of your top 36 of wide receivers. The consensus fantasy pros right now is wide receiver 43. There is no way Elijah Moore finishes that way. The Detroit Lions give up the 3rd most fantasy points to the wide receiver position on the year. So you need to be going to get Elijah Moore. It's not just going to be Garrett Wilson. We're monitoring the Corey Davis injury, but still, Elijah Moore has worked his way back into the starting lineup. He's working out of the slot. And as we've seen the last 2 games, 16 total targets, 4 total red zone targets, and 162 air yards over the last 2 games. Fire up your Elijah Moores as a flex consideration, and he should not be on your waiver wire.